In part two of our lesson on the sum and difference identities for sine and tangent, we will derive and use the sum and difference identities for tangent. We can write tangent of a plus b as sine of a plus b divided by cosine of a plus b. Next, we will use the sum identities for each of these. Sine of a plus b, we know, is sine a cosine b plus cosine a sine of b. And in the denominator, cosine of a plus b gets replaced with cosine a cosine b minus sine a sine b. What mathematicians were seeking when they worked on this proof was, since this is a tangent, they wanted to get the identity to be in terms of a tangent. So what they did was multiply by 1 in the form of 1 over cosine a cosine b over itself. So please note that this is just a fancy version of 1. All we're doing is taking this rational expression and multiplying by 1. Now let's look at the numerator first. We will have to distribute this over both terms. So we'll take this first multiplication and get sine of a cosine b divided by cosine a cosine b. Then we have a plus sign, and we will distribute to the second term, where we will get cosine a sine b over cosine a cosine b. Next, we'll look at the denominator, and we have to once again distribute. So distributing to that first term, we're going to get cosine a cosine b divided by cosine a cosine b. Then we have this minus sign, and we have to distribute this to the second term here and get sine of a sine of b divided by cosine a cosine b. So it probably, at this point, looks like we're making this thing so complicated. But watch what happens next. We can see in this first expression that cosine b in the numerator is going to cancel with cosine b in the denominator. We are left with sine of a over cosine of a, which is tangent of a. Then we have this plus sign. In the second expression, we have cosine a in the numerator canceling with cosine a in the denominator. We have sine b over cosine b, which we know is tangent B? The first term in the denominator, we have cosine A cosine B over cosine A cosine B. Both of these are going to cancel out and we'll be left with a 1. And we have a minus sign. Sine of A over cosine of A is tangent of A, and that has to multiply sine of B over cosine of B, which is tangent of B. And this is the sum identity for tangent. Now, as we've done for some of the other identities, to prove the difference identity for tangent, we can now turn this into a sum. So this is tangent of A plus a negative B. And now we'll apply the sum identity for tangent, which says to take the tangent of the first, which is A, plus the tangent of the second, negative B, divided by 1 minus the tangent of the first, A, times the tangent of the second, negative B. We can remind ourselves of the negative angle identities for tangent. Tangent of negative theta is equal to negative tangent theta, and that's because tangent is odd. So if we put that in, we get tangent of A. Now this tangent of negative B is going to become negative tangent B, so this will become minus tangent B. In the denominator, we have 1 minus tangent of A times negative tangent B. So this will simplify to tangent A minus tangent B divided by 1. Now we have a minus sign here and a negative here, so this is going to turn into plus tangent A tangent B. So this will be the difference identity for tangent. In this example, we have to find the exact value of the tangent of 11 pi over 12. As we've done before, we have to find a combination of the special angles that will add up to be 11 pi over 12. So we start listing them. Pi over 6 we know is 2 pi over 12. Pi over 4 would be 3 pi over 12. Pi over 3 would be 4 pi over 12. The next special angle is pi over 2, which would be 6 pi over 12. We're starting to get closer because these two would add to 10 and we need 11. After pi over 2, The next special angle is 2 pi over 3, which would be 8 pi over 12. And now we see that's going to do it. We've got 3 pi over 12 plus 8 pi over 12 would add to be 11 pi over 12. So that means we're going to use pi over 4 and 2 pi over 3 in our sum. So when we come back over here to tangent of 11 pi over 12, we can rewrite it as the tangent of pi over 4 plus 2 pi over 3. We know the identity for tangent of a plus b is that it equals tangent of a plus tangent of b divided by 1 minus tangent a tangent b. Now we need to plug into that. So then tangent of 11 pi over 12 is going to equal tangent of the first, which is pi over 4, plus tangent of the second, 2 pi over 3, divided by 1 minus tangent of the first, so tangent pi over 4, times tangent of the second, 2 pi over 3. We can now fill in the trig function values. We know that the tangent of pi over 4 is equal to 1 plus, we've got the tangent of 2 pi over 3. Now we know that 2 pi over 3 is in quadrant 2. We know the reference angle would be pi over 3. So we know off of our special angle chart, the value is going to be radical 3, and because it's in quadrant 2, it has to be negative radical 3. That's our numerator. In the denominator, we have 1 minus the tangent of pi over 4, which is 1, times tangent of 2 pi over 3, which we just learned is negative root 3. The numerator becomes 1 minus radical 3, and the denominator becomes 1 plus radical 3. Now we have to rationalize this fraction. We are not allowed to leave a radical in the denominator. So we're going to multiply by 1 in the form of the conjugate over itself. So 1 minus radical 3 over 1 minus radical 3. We use the conjugate of the denominator over itself. In the numerator, we have to square 1 minus radical 3. So that's going to equal 1 minus 2 radical 3 plus radical 3 squared, which is 3. In the denominator, we have the special product of a plus b times a minus b, which we know is a squared minus b squared. So we get 1 squared, which is 1, minus radical 3 squared, which is 3. The numerator, combining like terms, we get 4 minus 2 radical 3. In the denominator, we have negative 2. Because we have a negative 2 in the denominator, we can see we could actually factor a negative 2 if we wanted to out of the numerator. So if we factor negative 2 out of the numerator, then it's going to become negative 2 plus radical 3. That whole thing is over negative 2. negative 2 in the numerator will cancel with negative 2 in the denominator, and we get negative 2 plus radical 3. And this is the simplest form of our result. Just a couple of reminders here, because I really want to help you be successful on this stuff. Be sure to write down the identity that you're going to use first. It will really help you remember to put in all the parts you have to put in. Then make sure that you substitute in the angles and use your special angle chart to figure out their function values. We have to rationalize, can't leave any radicals in the denominator, and when the denominator is in this form, we have to rationalize by using the conjugate of the denominator over itself. You have to make sure you fully reduce each rational expression and leave your answer in simplest terms. For your convenience, I've created a summary chart here where you can put all the sum and difference identities in one place. We learned that the cosine of a plus b is equal to cosine a cosine b minus sine of a sine of b. And the cosine of a minus b, the only difference will be that this minus in the previous formula becomes a plus. So this is cosine a cosine b plus sine of a sine of b. The sine of a plus b is sine a cosine b plus cosine a sine b. And the sine of a minus b is sine of a cosine b minus cosine a sine b. So again, these two only differ by the plus and minus sign. And one of the memorization techniques you'll have to pay attention to is that the sign, the plus goes with the plus and the minus goes with the minus, where for the cosine it's the opposite. We found out that tangent of a plus b is tangent a plus tangent b divided by 1 minus tangent a tangent b. And the tangent of a minus b is tangent a minus tangent b over 1 plus tangent a tangent b. And again, these two only differ by a sign. And one of the ways I remember this is the plus goes with the plus in the numerator, and the denominator is always the opposite. If I have a plus in the numerator, I'm going to have a minus in the denominator. If I have a minus in the numerator, I have a plus in the denominator. And the plus goes with the plus, the minus goes with the minus. And of course, all of these identities you need to memorize as soon as you can, so I strongly suggest you write these down 2-3 times a day, and also write them down every time you go to use them in your homework problems, because then you kind of get to memorize them for free.